someone moving in across the street.
Well, maybe they'll have a girl your age. It'd be nice for you to have a friend.
What a great series this is. And I just want to start off with the title, which to me is so heavy with meaning. It's that place in our past, in everybody's past, that is treasured, that was seminal, that was important, you know, that you carry with you the rest of your life. And I just wonder if that had any kind of reverberation for you, Sarah.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, for me, it's the street that my childhood home was on. And I think that, you know, when we drove onto the set at Firefly Lane, it was, I mean, you just got goosebumps. Like, I don't know how they found this magical place. These two homes that are supposed to be across the street from each other that are, and the, you know, what you're seeing in the show, those weren't built sets. Those are both the actual interiors of the homes that are on Firefly Lane, or the location they picked for Firefly Lane. And this street is just magical, and the green and the trees, it's kind of takes your breath away.
They became, to everyone who knew them, simply Tully and Kate.
And for more than 30 years, that friendship was the bulkhead of their lives.
Roan, this is a series about female friendship that goes over decades. And I don't remember very easily anything like it, really, in terms of drama. I can think of some sort of comedy ones. So this is a real rarity. And I wonder if you'd just comment on that.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's a total rarity in the sense that it's something with so much heart and but then also it's a show I think that'll have you like crying 1 minute and then like laughing hysterically the next. And I think it's really unique in that sense. And I also think that, you know, this kind of portrayal of female friendship is a rarity, where it's just a deep dive into what it means to be two women in friend love, you know? And I think that that's really special. And I think it'll really speak to people in the sense that, you know, you fall hard and fast in friend love when you're 14, and you're very fortunate if that friendship endures. And in this case it does. And I think that that'll be really touching to anyone watching it, because it is kind of universal, that feeling of like deep platonic love.
You don't get it. You don't know what it's like to fail, and you succeed at everything you try.
Sarah, the series is 10 episodes, and you're focal. And when you saw that lay ahead of you, obviously that's a huge challenge. And was it daunting at all?
You know, it's interesting. When I read the script, I immediately fell in love with it. I laughed, I cried, I wanted to be a part of it right away. And there were challenges that would push me so far out of my comfort zone. And it's one of the reasons I wanted to do it. You know, as an actor, that's exciting and rare. But then there were challenges that came along as we went that I didn't know about, that were really exciting. And, you know, when you're in your 40s and you're wearing very little clothing, and that is daunting. But what was even more daunting than that was singing in public, doing karaoke when I was kicked out of the choir and I can't sing in front of 100 people with no sound in the room other than my own grating voice, and you just have to go for it. But you know, it's what kept the job so fun, and no 2 days were the same. It was truly every day I pinched myself and I was like, how is this my job? Because, you know, we would have days where you're doing drama and you're doing comedy. Definitely a job like no other, and I'm so grateful for it.
Live from Seattle, this is Tully Heigl.
You crossed the line, Tully. You don't even know there is a line.
The music might have changed with the decades,
but the promises made on Firefly Lane remained.
Best friends forever.